came over and offered. He's a better match.
Well, they were getting after Chara, and watch the exchange between the two. There's the first, there's the response, there's the book. Don't back up that tree. Don't write that check if you can't cash it.
How's your dental insurance? Spitting chiclets. Brawls out to make the save on the bad angle drive from Kevin Adams. And now it gets nasty as Chara gets the Dukes up with David Krejci. Now that is a huge talent mismatch, and Chicago will be very pleased about this. But Chara has two good straight rights. Krejci trying to trade. Chara stumbles down, gets back up. He's going up and under and over, and Krejci looks like he's making a donation to the Red Cross here.
There is blood spattering all over the circle. Chara wins on cuts.
Listed at 6'2", 225. He is not a small man, but...
Yeah, he's still giving 40 pounds away to Chara. And there's Sagan. The play started in the neutral zone, and Sagan went down. It was on the near side board, so I couldn't see it immediately to my right. That's where he went down. Did he get hit with a stick? It looks like he got stuck with a stick. I'd have to see that one again. And there's Chara.
Yeah, it was
Chara
Emelin that hit him. So Chara made a beeline right at Emelin.
Let's take one more look at Emelin coming across on Sagan.
Chatan one hand to the near post. Savard's backhander goes just wide. Chatan is tangling up with Downey. Oh, boy. This is not the matchup the Bruins want. Chatan covers up Downey, an experienced scrapper. And Chatan, not well known for his fisticuffs, is probably the goal of the year for the Bruins. Chara with a big hit on Downey. Chara takes a hard right from Downey. We explained this in the last game. Now Chara's going to go. He's just about sick and tired of this little punk. Oh, man! The big guy is just unloading. Downey says, "Where am I? Mommy, help!"
Just what we talked about, Jack. After he dropped the gloves on Chatan, Chatan not returning to the Bruin lineup. Chatan and Chara obviously friends, but teammates first. And Chara with a score, 5-0.
Looking for a little late game magic. They're down by two with 6.5 minutes left. Haula upended in the offensive end as Tatar sent Haula head over heels. And now they're shoving at each other. And will they go? Yes, they will. These two don't drop the gloves often. Eric Haula and Thomas Tatar. Tatar landing a right, couple of rights on Haula despite losing a helmet.
Well, as you mentioned, neither of these guys, this really part of their game, but Haula did not like the low hit by Tatar. And the two of them go after one another. That'll be the end of it, as they'll sit down now for five apiece. Here's a look at the hit. You see Tatar low hip check. The puck was gone.
Smith was really giving a shift in there, and you can see that coming. Smith got into the corner a little bit earlier in the shift, and he let a whack go on Panic, and away we go.
Well,
got popped over in the right wing corner. It started with Connick with a hard, hard hit. Smith wanted a penalty here. He felt he got hit up in the draw, turned around, took a number. Connick, we showed his great ability with his hands on the goal in the second period. There's the original slash. And then, boy, that's a right cross that very nearly caught Smith on the button.
Two, Fionn swings it around the boards. This is the first of three meetings between these two teams. Valesky doing some pushing and shoving with Chernak, and the punches are flying.
Now, Chernak's a big physical player. He's 225 pounds.
.443 to go. Valesky getting involved with 6'4" Eric Chernak.
Both benches are completely